Funders, and welcome to another episode. Another one of our final episodes before we finish off the year. I'm Sam Wood. BJ, thanks for joining us. Paddy, how are you?
Woodhead, the winner's circle this week. Oh, it's great to hand the trophy over for the winner's circle, mate. Here you go. There you are.
No, that's you're going across. You've got to hand it down. Yeah. No, you've got to hand it down.
Handed it the wrong way.
Obviously, mate. All our heads are in different places on the screen.
Oh, sorry, $12.
Mike, can you pass it to Woodhead? $12, Zaydani. What a ride. Straight up the fence. Luke Nolan again.
Luke Nolan.
She rails like a greyhound.
I'll tell you what. If you watched its last three wins, you would get confused about which is which because it's done the exact same thing. Just railed.
Thanks for making a big deal about it. I haven't tipped me hat, let alone a winner, the last couple of weeks.
Back in form.
I shared the winner's circle with Pat the week before. Like, you should jump in.
No, I don't think it was.
I got it wrong in that episode. I'll get it wrong in this episode.
About a week ago, you heard me crying. Mate, I just cannot tip winners. What do I do? I said, firstly, turn your race book up. It's upside down.
Well, it's pretty easy in Perth. You just have to find William Pike.
Yeah, well, the rollover bet wasn't Pikey phenomenal.
10 races, he rode 5 out of 9 winners.
He rode 5 and he was on the last 2 favourites. So there was a possibility that he was going to ride 7.
Yeah, but let me say, they still bagged him.
I know. There's still some butchers. still plenty of people calling him the butcher.
Oh, God, he coughs it like...
Jesus, the people that bag him at the end of a race day like that must watch the Titanic and get filthy that it run into an iceberg. They must just think that the world is at the end of a rainbow every time, because if you were still launching into those last 2 favourites after he's ridden 5-fer, you are just the most, you're the most optimistic person I've ever met.
But Imagine if you had it all up, like a parlay. Yeah, you had a 7-fer going. That would have been nice. Even a
5-fer
was good.
There were people in the comments filthy that the last, like, be like, let us down in the last 2 legs of our 19-leg multi. Like, oh, gosh.
The last 2 were heavily backed, especially the one in the last. I know that was one of DJ Constable's best bets of the day, but just unlucky. Got beat by 40-1 shot. Like, please, you can't do anything about that. You can't coach that stuff.
You and I, Pat, were talking on Saturday morning, I think, figuring out where the bookies were going to make their money. Remember? With the Pikey, you know, where's it going to capitulate? Are they going to hammer it? Are they going to stay away? And then...
I said about 6.25, he was on a thing at about 20-1.
Yeah.
Well, they're not going to make their money there.
No.
What is like, mate, the favourite in the last will have to get beat. Well, they doubled their money with the last... The last 2 heavily back. And do you know what? He rode Western Empire Retreat. He rode the earlier feature race Retreat. He's, mate, he is a freak. He is an absolute freak. And anyone that wants to bag him, please don't.
You know what? Anyone that wants to bag him.
Don't do it in my vicinity.
Yeah, go back and listen to the interview that Pat and I had with him, the show that we did with him. He's very generous of his time. He's just a real laid-back country guy. One of the nicest dudes you could meet.
Not only that, too. I think when we're 80 years old, 70 years old, and you hear stories from older people at the racetrack, I don't reckon there'll be anyone that won't know some sort of folk story about William Pike, because he's known by... Even Shaq knows him.
Yeah.
Like in the last. Yeah, he does. Yeah. Shaq knows him.
Yeah, exactly.
Even Shaq knows him.
I think we'll get to see him in Melbourne again next spring as well, because that horse is a very good horse, Western Empire. We had the rollover bet on him too. Well done, Woodhead.
Yeah.
In a circle.
Can I say too?
Just great, isn't it?
Why can't a horse like that be in every week? Yeah, or like Zaki.
Why didn't you have it on Zaydani?
I don't know.
We're getting serious about the rollover, because we're going to get it.
I got a good one for 10 us
in a row.
Good one for us.
I actually.
But yeah, how far do you reckon he can get Western Empire, Pat? Were you Cox seriously mate. Impressed?
Oh, mate, I was. I said it before. before a run last week, I said that this horse will be flogging this field and then they'll be taking it to Melbourne. So, yeah, I think it has it got into single figures in the Cox?
No, I think he's about 12 to 1.
Yeah, there's no value there, I don't think. But it's a freak, this horse.
If he's there on if he's there on Cox Plate Day, he'll start a lot shorter than that.
Yeah, I can't but wait. I can't wait to see you come across.
You get your money back anyway at this stage, so
I think he could be one of the best. And we've had Regal Power win an All-Star Mile. We've had Celeb Queen come over and you know do itself no harm in the sprint races, running behind your Masked Crusaders and all that sort of stuff. I think this one could be the best of them all.
Well, the All-Star,
Arcadia Queen, sorry, as well.
I agree. This horse might be the best that's come from the West in a long time.
Yeah.
These are big wraps. These are very, very big wraps.
I didn't know how good he was, but that race was over a long way from home, and his turn of foot, he looks like he's won a derby. He's going to run 2,400 meters. All-Star Miles, not out of the question. I'd probably prefer to see him give him a long break and bring him back for the spring. But he'd probably that All-Star Mile. If he goes, I think him or I'm Thunderstruck would be at the top of the list for that race for mine.
You were bullish, Pat. You weren't. It wasn't just, I'd be interested to see, you know, we've got a big wraps on it. You know, not a lot of times you kind of just want to dip your toe in the water because we're heading west and, you know, it could just be the hype over there. But you were not, you did not hold back. You knew that this thing was just.
Oh, mate, what about the money that came for it too? They were still backing at $1.50. They were still backing at $1.45.
What did it actually get SP into?
$1.40, I think.
Yeah, $1.45 or something like that. But
it's still good for the way it beat him.
The market knew how good a horse he is.
Well, they listened
to the body. He stayed out of trouble and he was too good for them. I'd love to see him in a Cox Plate.
How good though when you're on at even money and you are and they're still firming at $1.45 and that's the best. I love that.
As if you do love it, you would have sat there and gone, oh God, I wish I put more on it.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was
thought. I got scratching the walls.
I had a choice, get my last name tattooed across my back or that. So I got that.
Did you take the double with the guineas?
No.
That would have been your go.
I didn't. No doubles for me, mate. I do you know what? I sat and watched the West. I didn't get involved. I thought we've got our rollover bit going there. I'm happy enough. I didn't want to do my carnival money in the West.
No.
We'll just save it up for Christmas.
We'll save it up for Magic Millions, actually.
Magic Millions, isn't that turned into a shit fight trying to get bloody accommodation and venues and things like that? It's we might have left the run too late.
We'll be right.
Oh, okay. BJ's confident. We're doing it.
It always just falls into place.
We're doing it 3 months out. But you know what? It is telling me. And we're having a bit of problem with venues. And a couple of guys got in touch with us. Some I've got back to, some I haven't. We can't get exactly what we want. But what it does tell me with the hype and the zero vacancy area is Millions is back. Everybody is back on the Gold Coast next year or in January for Magic Millions, and we cannot wait. And we will be at the Calcutta on Thursday night, and we're getting a horse.
Hopefully we draw a cool and
we're getting a horse. Honeypot?
I'm not even.
We had a futures bet on the weekend, didn't I? Convinced you and DJC to have a futures bet on the weekend.
I know. I'm not a futures better, but I'm glad you didn't tell us to back it in that actual race.
Oh my God. Did you see this, Blake? I don't know if I put that into our message.
I think you've left me out of that group. So
but the motivation for the I want to nab another big future since you tipped Kissam. Kissam.
Honeypot.
It tried to run the race like a person. Mate,
it nearly popped out the top of the barrier. So it was reared up, and then they hit the switch on the gates.
So what price did you take?
In the Magic Millions, 16. Yeah.
Oh, that's
17s.
That's
no, good.
No,
we got 17.
He's out to 21 now. So
it's not out to 20. Is it?
It is. I'm just looking at the sports bet. So, should I dive in now?
Effing
love.
I reckon we go again, boys.
Back the trip.
We should go again. We should go again. We should have had more on.
We'll just have more on the favourite. Coolangatta is a star.
What's Coolangatta like? $2.20
Golden Slipper. $2.20 I'll show you. I've got a good ticket on Coolangatta to win the Golden Slipper, actually, at $19. So
I heard a rumor it wasn't going to Magic Millions, and then I asked a friend, and he said, "That's a lie. It's going to Magic Millions."
Yeah, of course, it's going to Magic Millions. I can't. Is it really a 20?
As far as I know, she'll be there. It will be very hard to beat the 3-year-old Magic
Honey Millions. Honey Pot's 21.
Far out, Woodhead. Do you know what though? If those gates opened, it was a good run.
They did open. Unfortunately, the horse was in the air. Anyone go back and have a look at it? It was Sunny Coast on the weekend. Sunday.
It won't. Yeah, the gym crack winner was super impressive.
Yeah, she's pretty good. She's pretty special.
So, futures bet. Me.
On the 21s.
We got 13s or something. And I convinced you all to take a futures bet now. Punters Club too, for the Patriots.
That's right.
The Patriots, yeah. What happened there?
He or she.
We lost the price on that as well. 18s and 13s. No, you didn't give me the thumbs up. We took 13s. It's okay.
To win how much? Two?
One. Oh, I can go two. Don't worry about me.
Let's go.
It's our money. I can load up. If all three of us say yes, I'll have it. Yes. Majority rules in our punters club.
I don't know what you're talking about, but just, you better ask.
Just pretend you're... No,
probably
he's not in this
the
one either.
Don't know what you're talking about either,
Oh, so. Okay, sorry. Anyway, back to the Patriots. I reckon they're really good.
Mate, you can just get... Do you know what? Footy talk on the Collingwood podcast.
Who cares about NFL?
Okay. Wow. Thanks, fellas. Is there anyone else to leg up from the weekend? Obviously, we go through our leg up. What jockey you want to leg up onto yours based on their fantastic effort or ride last weekend? Pat, are you looking at anyone other than Brock Ryan?
Oh, what a way to leave your apprenticeship behind. And just
unbelievable.
To do that. And the faith shown in him by the Price training partnership was, it's good to see. It's good for racing. It's good to see. Count to Rupee, freak of a horse. It's very impressive. Very impressive riding performance and very impressive horse.
It was a great ride. I think he got 10 meetings for it too.
So fair.
He got suspended because he gave Kieran McAvoy a shave, I think. So
chop someone out at the start. You got to do what you got to do, I guess. Yeah, and all's fair if no one gets hurt, I guess.
All's fair in love and warfare. No, but mean, it wasn't, like it wasn't too bad. Just wasn't too bad. He just
had to come across to the wide barrier.
He just wasn't clear when he just gave Kieran McAvoy a bit of a tighten up, and McAvoy had to sort of steady up. You know, just like when you pull out in front of another car and they have to ease up a little bit.
Okay,
that's fair.
Yeah.
Fair.
Yeah.
And you shave their bumper. They keep driving.
He pulled off two terrific rides, actually. Divine Breath, it drew 18 as well for Teresa Bader, and he found one off the fence on that, and she proved too good for them. And then he's backed it up on the big stage. Like, it's not easy for an apprentice. He doesn't get to claim in that race, and drew 17. Favorite finds one off the fence, and I think he counted to 20 before he let him down. He was traveling so well, and he just exploded. He's going to be a very good horse. He improves with every run, and the connections are actually talking Everest for him. I don't think we'll see him at a mile too much.
They'd obviously had a fair bit of drink on.
Calm down, guys.
He's a good horse. He's an improving type, and I guess
I know there were some desperate slot holders last year, but
God, really, he
some desperate
like Pat,
slots to be giving that away.
Pat, if he won a benchmark 78 first up, and if I had a spruced you Golden Eagle for this horse,
you've always said the Gong is a good lead up race for the Everest.
We'll see. I think you'll be able to snag a spot.
Oh, please. I think there's going to be some good 3-year. I'm hoping that there's going to be some good 3-year-olds come through this year, and it's going to be a bit strong, deeper.
Well, don't worry. The Everest had a very long tail this year. Had 5 or 6 horses that absolutely couldn't win.
Yeah.
He would have beat a few home this year, probably.
Maybe.
because he's the right sort of horse, because he's got a high cruising speed and he's got a turn of foot. So I'm not saying that he could win a race like that, but he's not going to cut himself up on the speed and capitulate. He's going to find a spot on the back of a hot speed and go past a few tired ones.
Don't get me wrong. I think the horse has improved, but it's coming to the end of the preparations for a lot of these horses in the Gong. And yeah, I'm not getting carried away with it. I think speaking Everest terms for a horse like this is, you know, hopefully if it continues to improve, if it continues on that trajectory, then maybe, but.
They can only dream.
Pat's really puffing out these dreams for these owners. Everest.
Maybe the Kosciuszko. maybe a smaller mountain.
Yeah.
I don't think he's eligible for a Kosciuszko, but maybe he'll go to like what do they call that? Base camp. Maybe it'll be
Everest base camp. That would actually
that's a good race.
Remember we're talking about that? We actually talked about those ones that couldn't make the Everest. It should be called base camp.
Base camp, a 600-meter sprint race. Run it.
It's called the Sydney Stakes, but yeah, they should call it Base Camp.
Base Camp, yeah.
It's a great name. We should tweet Volandis and tell him next year.
Mate, yeah, then something scratches, call it up from Base Camp.
Yeah. I love it. Sit there waiting.
It's a good idea. Okay. Well, I'll tell you who I'm legging up this week.
Who?
Poor old Tommy Berry.
What's wrong with Tommy?
Six rides on Saturday.
Oh, Tommy Melbourne.
Six rides on Saturday and he rode 5 seconds in the winner.
Wow.
So wow, hey.
I think he deserves a leg up.
Still a good day for his pocket.
Can I throw in one?
Pocket's okay.
Can I throw in one more?
And yeah, go ahead.
Like you hate to pull anyone down for having an opinion, but Blakey Johnson, your old man through the week, coming out and saying that J-Mac is up there comparable to Muhammad Ali, he's put the mocker on him.
That's okay.
He come out and didn't ride a winner on the weekend.
He rode the last winner.
Oh, okay, yeah, the thing of Bjorn's.
Yeah, Dynamic Impact.
I turned it off by then. I was waiting for Dynamic Impact.
But yeah, J-Mac.
You would have called your mum straight away. What about what Mal did during the week?
Mum's the one that told me about it.
Muhammad Ali.
The greatest of all time. I reckon J-Mac would have got a very big kick out of that.
Oh, 100%. It's coming from one champion to another.
What else did your dad say something else during the week about he gave out the nicknames in the change rooms or something?
Who? My dad said that?
Yeah, your dad.
I do know that that's true, that he gave a few people their nicknames. He gave himself
the nickname Miracle Mouth. Anyway, did we get any information about the dad off?
We did.
What was it?
I sent you the info through the week. It was the horse called More Minx. He nearly knocked off Kingston Town at 100-1 in the Premier Stakes in Sydney.
The Premier Stakes?
Premier Stakes, yeah. The old man nearly knocked off Kingston Town.
Were they good mates back then?
Yeah. I think they've always been. Because Mal was with TJ Smith, Dad was with Beat Horan, and I guess it was all just the same circle.
Well, I wouldn't mind seeing the replay of that race. We have to find it now. YouTube, I suppose. I
don't know if that'd be around.
I don't know. Did they even film the race back then? Someone drew it.
It was on the radio. Remember, you know when they do it in the cricket and they pretend someone's bowling, hit the pitch?
Double bouncer.
Should we get into this week's races? We are here, there, and everywhere. I'm going to take you
to the West first.
Let's end in the West. We're at Group One. Give it some respect. We finish with the Group Ones every other episode. Here, just because it's Perth, it's like, oh, just get the Group One out of the way.
The WA government deserve it because they haven't opened the borders up.
It's a restricted horses. Group One. So technically, it probably should be like the Magic Millions and unrated this year.
They can come up, Magic Man.
I agree.
Let's not turn our attention to the Gold Coast.
It's only if you bought them from the Magic Million sales, you can run at the Magic Millions thing. And another another thing about the race on the weekend, can't wait to see 11-11 go up there and try and win again, another $1 million. It's that horse has won $2.8 million or something like that.
That was massive on the weekend.
I know, phenomenal. That's so, so well placed for
horses. There's actually a lot of late talk about that horse too.
It's just if you've got a good one from one of those sales, you can compete in the 2-year-old race, the 3-year-old race, and then you've got the sprint, the stayers. Like, it doesn't matter. Like,
it's brilliant.
You can go and target that meeting every year if you've got a good enough one.
And you get a whole week up there.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But they all come up for the wave and just stay for the millions, according to the Gold Coast Turf Club.
Yeah, that guy's a flop.
That guy doesn't know what he's talking about. All right, let's get Ascot out of the way. Race 8, 1,200 metres, the Group 1, Crown Perth. I will mention that sponsor just in case. Winterbottom Stakes. Wowee. What's our prize money here? $1 million. Bang. Elite Street, $2.60. Wilchino, $4.40. Graceful Girl with our man Willie Pike on board at $8. Red Can Man, $15. Indian Pacific, $16. Oh, it's a big old field. Flutini's in here, Pat. One of your faves.
Mate, there's a few of them. Remember we did this whole card last...
I feel like we were half successful last year as well.
Winterbottom Stakes. Yeah, mate, you actually went quite well over in the West.
Ah, you know, I do my best work. West.
You say best in the West.
The pest from the West. Flirtini, 41s. Patty, what... Where are we looking for this year's edition of the Winterbottom Stakes?
As much as you could try and look around the favourite, Elite Street did it last year at $34 and did it easy enough. Comes up against a way easier field this year. There's no horses from the East coming this year. So technically you got to say it won it last year. Why couldn't it do it this year in an easier field? Similar preparations where last year it come off winning two benchmark 72s. This year, it comes into it winning a Group 3 and a listed race. So beating all the similar horses in this race.
Yeah.
Try to make a case for Pikey's horse because it's Pikey's horse. And I just wanted to tip Pikey, but it meets Graceful Girl better at the weights, better barrier than Graceful Girl. I can just see this horse dominating this race. So no reason to go outside the favourite here.
Yeah, I tend to agree.
I'm going to say except for...
Oh, here we go.
The horse coming out of the benchmark 72, the rating 72, Wilchino.
Oh, the one down the bottom.
It's won seven in a row.
The mare. A mare in four. Hey.
She's got a hope. But I'm gonna have something small on her just as an interest bet. She's drawn four. She's going to be making her own luck on the speed comparatively to the favourite, who's probably going to have a few lengths to make up. He's going to be...
But do they ever walk there? They never walk there.
No, they're not going to walk. But personally, I'd prefer to back a horse that's going to put himself into the race and you're taking a bit of luck out of the equation.
It's like Macau there. It's like if there's a race to the 400-metre pole.
And it's not easy to win... seven in a row. Like that's her winning record. She's won 8 from 11.
Very well placed. Very, very well placed this horse.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. But deserves her crack.
Yeah. But four back, it's in a no metro Saturday class race, winning that 66 or 72. It's a big step up to Group 1 class. I know Elite Street did it last year, but that's where I'm coming from the other side of things and saying that Elite Street... Superior prep this year. It's already made the improvement. Should be beating.
What about the ex Michael Wayne and John Hawkes horse Outrageous? We can say that there is a horse from the West over there. Training change, Michael Wayne and John Hawkes to Luke Fernie. Never heard of him personally, but no. I don't watch too much
personally Ascot racing. They should have either sent this horse to Tasmania or Northern Territory. Because
Laverod has raced over in the East as well, hasn't it?
It did. It won a few nice races too.
It didn't.
Actually, just having a quick look at Outrageous's old form. He likes this day. He won the Festival of Stakes this day last year.
Yeah, and, really? sin- And since then, mentally, it's retired.
Well, he's
physically, it's still running around.
Physically,
he's beat two horses home in his last four. And he's got form around Laverod.
Just cruising.
Yeah.
All right. So, Paddy, you got Elite Street on top. BJ, you're having a small bet on Wilcino. And I have to go with the informal jockey. Obviously.
In the West.
Head Willie Pike's way. So, graceful girl, $8. Yeah, why not? Why not?
Like, you're the great man navigating from barrier 18.
Yeah, he's really got to do his work. He's got his work cut out for him.
That'll be one of Pike's best because this horse just goes back to last, and that's where he does his best work.
Like I said, go back and listen to an interview and we talk about how he rides, and he just lets the horse just do the work. And the only other person I've heard come out and speak like that was actually Jamie Carr after her win on Nature Strip. That's how she likes to ride him, so... A little bit of something, a little bit of insight, you know, behind the scenes, industry stuff. Industry stuff, guys.
Bit of something going on.
Industry stuff. Okay, Sydney, Melbourne. What do you reckon, boys?
Let's head up to Sydney.
Okay.
Let's go. Festival Stakes.
We're going to do the Festival Stakes, Race 8, 1,500 metres at Rose Hill. A current outright favourite, $2.90, Ellsberg. Brutality is our second favourite, $8.50. Bandersnatch. Order Again, Art Cadeau, all on the $10 line. Lena's Hero, Kubrick, Kerwin's Lane, Alma Haha. This is actually a lovely looking race. BJ, are you going to kick us off here?
Yes, it's not a bad little race. We are expecting a bit of rain in Sydney over the next couple of days. So my tip is quite weather dependent.
It just pissed down before.
We're currently on a soft 7, but anything better than a soft 6, and this horse is a good thing. Soft 7, he probably still wins, but I think Ellsberg is one of the better bets of the day in Sydney. At this stage, he's my best of the day. Drawn well, comes in with 53 kilos. He carried level weights with horses like I'm Thunderstruck and Count Ruby. We saw what he did in the Gong last week. He was actually off the speed in that race, which is not usually this horse's go. And now he's fourth up at 1,500 metres, a distance that he is at his best, and he's won two at this track before. So I think he's going to be seriously hard to beat. He's going to be making his own luck on the speed. And Ellsberg, very, very hard to beat for mine.
Ellsberg, 290.
I actually think he'll get out a little bit on the day. So I think pending what happens with the weather, but with the forecast, he'll probably get out on Friday, and then if the rain doesn't come, he'll firm right back up on Saturday. But I think if we're on a soft 7, he'll probably start 350, something like that. But I think that's a really good price for this horse. So I have him clear top pick.
Paddy, you got a say in this race?
Yeah, there's two that I like in this race. I couldn't split them on top. I thought that carry some good odds. So maybe marry them up with Blakey's best bet. I like Bandersnatch. You've got a bit of stable mail here. The camp after the first run was very unimpressed.
Hang on. This isn't your normal stable,
mate. What's going on here?
They wanted a hairdryer.
Six single mattresses.
Yeah. I just turned up with it. Who ordered the single mattresses?
If anyone wants those mattresses that come in the box, like really easy... High quality, just let us know, right?
Super high quality. It's cutting edge technology, but that is by the by. That's what I was trying to sell them when I turned up to the stable with them. The horses to sleep on.
Well, like you're like a door-to-door mattress.
Yeah, because they need king single, you idiot. But yeah, I heard the voice reports from last week, and all reports are a bit disappointed with the run last week. I know for a fact that they did think that it was going to probably run top two last week, but it wasn't meant to be. Got a stitch late. I reckon it needed the run. Who am I to tell MWJ, all the Hawkses, that it should have trialed twice, but it should have trialed twice. Needed the run. I think it'll be much better for it. I think this Bandit Snatch is a top horse, and they've got big plans for it. So I know that they're expecting it to run a big race. And at $10, I think it's definitely worth the risk. Another one, chopped out in the Goulburn Cup. Should have probably won the Goulburn Cup by panels and, just copped a check at the wrong time, lost all its momentum. Art Cadeau.
Art Cadeau, yeah.
It was a big, big run. And I think it's a nice horse on the up, well placed. Yeah, I think at $10, it's a bet too.
And you would have thought Tommy would have got the option to ride Bandersnatch as well, and he lands on Art Cadeau. He loves him and Terry Robinson. They've got a good thing going. So
saw him riding on the beach the other day, actually.
If anything beats my horse, I'd like to be Art Cadeau.
You're down there sunning yourself on the beach, Pat, and they're just wandering by it.
I was on Canberra Beach, Queanbeyan Beach, wherever it is.
So you're telling me that Tommy's driven down to Canberra?
Where's Terry Robinson? Right. He's somewhere down south.
Where did you say?
Hang on one sec.
I thought it was Canberra.
Terry, it's Shoalhaven Heads.
That's south coast. It's not Canberra. But either way.
Just cruise down, ride on the beach, drive back home.
But yeah, Tommy rides all the Terry Robinson's horses.
Oh right, I thought it was just something specific with Art Cadeau. I knew that.
Yeah, he's got a good thing going with Art
Cadeau. I'm gonna in the email and on the stories, Pat, I'm gonna have his Bandersnatch because I'm gonna take Art Cadeau. I agree. Tommy's a good judge.
And it was a bloody good run. It had every right.
Very unlucky, eh?
It had every right to turn it up in that Goulburn Cup after the check it copped and just walk over the line, but it still picked him up and probably ran two lengths off the winner. So well, that was a nice run. But yeah, I know Bandersnatch, it'll turn it around this run. Just got to stitch first up. We'll be better second up.
They were very disappointed. So was your brother, because him and I were punning together.
Yeah.
He thought he had the word Bandersnatch all the way. All right, boys, that's the Festival Stakes. Let's head to Sandown for the Sandown Guineas. Obviously, if the race is called the Sandown Guineas, we're at Sandown, right?
100%. We're at Sandown, aren't we?
Sandown.
I'm here with the horse. I'm here with the horse now.
Oh, you're there?
Yeah, I'm at Sandown for the
Sandown. Look around. Is everyone ready for Saturday?
Well, it doesn't look like they're getting ready. It looks like they're just packing up from Wednesday, but
we're racing there on Wednesday. For some reason, we're off to Caulfield for the Sandown Guineas.
What?
Yeah. Anyone know what's going on, Paddy? What's the news?
I hear next year they're running the Melbourne Cup at Randwick as well. Just to really...
At least it's still Melbourne.
Just to really confuse everyone.
They're running the Melbourne Cup in Geelong.
The rumour I've heard is that they wanted a bigger crowd. They wanted to be more accessible for the crowd and thought they'd get better numbers.
That's ridiculous.
Holding it at Caulfield. I think it is a bit. I think, what are you thinking? Like, if you are going to change the program, just change the race. Change the race name or drop that race.
They've already done that. But they've already changed the race name once before. But surely you can't. So what? Sandown Race Club gets all the proceeds from this race that's held at Caulfield.
I've got no idea, mate.
That can't be the case.
Yeah, probably right. It's like taking your home game to Wagga or something like that.
Ridiculous though. This is the stupidest thing I've ever heard. Unless for some reason that Sandown is unraceable at the moment.
Yeah, unfit for races. But
they raced on it today. Look, Sandown, you can have Wednesday, but we're gonna take your two biggest races.
I don't get this. I was excited for the zipping. I think that it should be. You know who wouldn't allow this to happen?
PVL.
Yeah. Peter Villiers.
He wouldn't cop.
Oh, I've got a bone to pick with him too.
Oh, here we go.
Hang on.
Yep. We had six races today at Gosford, a midweek meet. That is absolutely disgusting. And on Saturday, we got to sit through 10 races. 10 races is too many. We need to move the midway to Wednesday.
Hold on.
We're desperate at this time of year, though, Blake.
We've heard there was some Twitter action about this over the weekend where someone finalised the Twitter by saying Saturday night is for families.
Yes, it's correct.
Okay, hold on. Don't make that statement on behalf of the leg up.
It is for, I'll tell you, well,
I'll tell you what, there was a comment.
The last race is too late. First of all, nobody wants to be watching the last race at 7 o'clock on a Saturday night.
I know, we should be at Sunny Coast.
Work is finished and we're done.
Work is finished.
Yeah, and like, even Flindell tweeted about it a couple of weeks ago, saying that it was a joke that the last race was so late. And someone made him delete his tweet.
Oh, shit. There's a lot going on at the moment.
That someone was his thumb.
Yeah, wow.
Do you know what, though, Flindell?
You know what? Saturday nights is for the families only because we have to. It was up to us.
Otherwise, it'd be for the boys.
It would be for the boys.
Or the girls.
I'd prefer to.
You wouldn't go on a Friday night. You work till about 2 a.m. on Friday night doing form. So don't tell Saturday me you're going to hang out with the boys on Friday night.
I like Saturday nights. I like Saturday nights for sitting in front of the TV and watching a movie. We get takeaway on Saturday nights.
That's a week.
Depending how much money I've won on the day.
That's every week night for
Chinese night, babe.
Well, it is Tuesday. Saturday night would be
PVL. Move the midway to Wednesday and no late races on Saturday.
PVL would say some of this. Well, mate, we're throwing it in there for a bit of support for the winter bottom. The boys are chasing Pike, so why shouldn't they be chasing the last few races on us?
Yeah, they're trying to just get a little bit of.
Move it to Wednesday.
Move it midway to Wednesday. The six race card at Gosford on Wednesday.
Give them Wednesday.
Six races.
Nobody's going to travel as far as Sandown for this meet.
Yeah, exactly. Move it to Wednesday. Oh, they did.
They didn't even send it to headquarters.
Let's sink our teeth.
Oh, actually, I think Flemington's been they're doing the track. They've ripped the grass up and
planted
some new stuff.
AstroTurf. Like a big putting green.
They've tiled it. The Greeks bought it and they've tiled it.
It's all cement, just gets hosed every Saturday.
It's way easier.
The Sandown Guineas, race 6.
Where's
at Caulfield? 1600 meters.
I'll tell you what, this is a bad week just to get into racing because this will confuse the shit out of
you. Oh, yeah, absolutely. I had to sit here and look at it for 2 hours, I think. Festival Dancer. Matthew Smith's horse, 390, current fave. Brigantine, 440. Port Louis, we need to figure out what we're doing with Port Louis. It's 480. Cardinal Gem, 650. The rest are double figure odds. Paddy, kick us off here, please.
Well, I got to say that any of your friends that tipped you Creed Dearest last week, I'm sure they're going to be the same people. They're going to be the same stickos in the head.
Yeah.
That'll be tipping your Port Louis.
Go easy on Port Louis. He's not the same horse as.
And do you know what?
Blake's got a soft spot for Port
Louis. They'll possibly be tipping you Kubrick. In the festival stakes as well.
Well, Kubrick's won his last two, so those punters would be going all right.
Oh, goodness me. Goodness me, Pat.
Stop bagging Kubrick. Stick to the horse you're currently bagging.
Creed Dearest and Port Louis. No, okay. Port Louis, do you know what? This race is so lacking depth that I actually nearly almost tried to talk myself into tipping Port Louis and just couldn't bloody do it. I couldn't do it. So I am not going to be that guy that misses Festival Dancer again. This could be the three-year-old this season that we've been waiting for. It's on an unbelievable run.
Definitely not the three-year-old we've been waiting for. She might pick off this race, but she's no Fangirl or Espiona.
Wow. Well. Sit down, Patrick.
Well, Blake, the cup is half empty, isn't it?
I'm with her too.
You're
a bloody
glass half empty kind of guy, aren't you?
I think she's been very well placed and she won a very weak spring stakes, but this is a weak Sandown Guineas also. So commence.
Mate, I don't mind it. I'm tipping it. All right. Is that okay?
So is Blake. Is that bloody okay? Hold on, Blake. You're tipping it as well, aren't you?
Well, I think she'll win. I agree.
Bullshit,
with
it'll win. It will not win. It'll gap her.
No, but I just don't think, like, I don't think she's first class. She's been well played.
This could be the 3-year-old we've been waiting for.
No, it's not, you fat pig. Blake, watch your language. Don't talk to me like that first.
Sorry, Pat.
No, it's not. I'm also tipping it.
How confused have you made listeners, people new in racing? At the Sandown Guineas, when racing Caulfield, you are tipping a horse that you've told me I'm out of line tipping.
Yeah. Why does Festival Dancer win, Patrick?
Why does it win? Yeah. Because it's on a roll. I cannot believe I didn't tip it last week. I just thought that other horse had a lot more improvement in it, which it didn't. And I'll cop that on the chin. But I am not missing this horse again. And the punters haven't missed it early. I can't believe as soon as markets open, 750 into 390.
Well, we were snapped.
750 to 390.
Yeah.
That was... did Dill Gibbons ride it?
Dylan Gibbons did right last start. And
the first black type.
And the start before, he's been on it, hasn't he?
I'm guessing his jockey manager would have been trying to get this right.
Sand out.
In the group two. Yeah. He probably might have sent him to sand out. Dill, sand out.
Somehow, if Hildo pulled that off, Dylan would walk into sand down that day and go, oh, Luke, it's that Caulfield.
Luke, I think they're racing at Caulfield. No, they're not, Dylan. This will be easy. If no one's there, you'll win.
Yeah.
Even though Blake said you won't.
All due respect.
Even though Blake said you won't, but he's tipping it.
Yeah, it's a good rest. This is a good rest. I'm with it as well. Festival Dancer wins this. Send him here. 390.
Festival Dancer will win this and win 3-year-old of the season.
Of all time, ever.
Best. Best on ground.
All right. Okay. That was easy. On the same horse, Zipping Classic. One of our favourite Sandown races. Group 2, race 7, 2,400 metres. Zipping Classic. Spanish Mission. This is just a put-in, take-out job. Spanish Mission, $1.55. Warning, $5.50. Sound, Wentwood, Dr. Drill, Luna Flare, Silent Sovereign, Flash R, Skelm. Double figure odds. Plus, 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 plus. Peter Moody's new horse, Spanish Mission.
Yeah.
Paddy?
This horse is a star. Did it first up in the Melbourne Cup. Run very elegant to four lengths.
Yep.
Run incentivised to half a length. And then the fifth horse, I think, was six lengths off it. So this is a put-in take-out job. This will be my rollover bet.
Oh.
I think
Patrick, Spanish. I think
it's very safe money going on here.
Spanish Mission.
It's a good one. I like that field.
This is exciting, isn't it?
Weak. Yeah. This is a nice horse. Like, this is a very, very nice horse. So, yeah. Weak field. Do you know what? It's a disappointing field, too, because I don't think it's a fitting end to the Melbourne Carnival or what it deserves, a 2-mile race to finish the carnival. It's, it's pretty sad.
Yeah,
Zipping would be would not be happy with this.
I'm just finding the rollover bet from last week, so I can put it on for you, Pat.
Thank you, Blakey. In saying that, I know Warning is going well and beat a small field last up, but it was a small field of Nuff Nuffs.
Yeah, look at that Nuff Nuff field.
Yeah, did you have any data? Did you have a look at it?
Who, me?
You all wooded.
I agree. At weight for age, Spanish Mission is thrown in. So he's gonna be seriously hard to beat. And if he hadn't come through that run in the Melbourne Cup well, then there's no way that Moods would be sending him around. So
right off the bat, owners.
Gee, boss. I think apparently the owners have thrown him a bone because he couldn't ride incentivize throughout the spring campaign. So
yeah.
He's going to be hard to beat.
Looking at the field, though, I thought this horse would be $1.15. And I know it's not overs getting $1.55, but well, it's
$1.55. He's overs if he should be $1.15.
Explain that to me, Beej. They, you think the owners have thrown Glenn Boss a bone because
he couldn't... Bossy was supposed to ride incentivize for the spring campaign, but he couldn't get there.
Sent him away.
Yeah, he couldn't get there because of COVID.
How ridiculous. Right, okay. He went to Northern Territory to quarantine to go to Melbourne, and then they knocked on his door after he got there for half an hour and said, you got to go back to Sydney.
It absolutely was ridiculous.
Yeah. I have no idea about this story. So he's got what? This is prior to the Spring Carnival?
Yes.
So he was going to base his entire family in Melbourne. Well, not his entire family, him and his wife.
Wow. And he's gone and done his 2 weeks in...
No, he only got half an hour into his 2 weeks.
He flew to Darwin.
Flew to Darwin to do it at that special place where the all the Olympians and all that sort of stuff
quarantine.
And they, so they got in the room and then they resold him straight away.
Here we go. We got the rollover there. Boom. Bureaucracy. We got 1.1.
That's unbelievable.
So we get back 152.63 when he wins.
All right, send that to me. I'll put it up in tips and slips.
Slow and steady, baby. Slow and steady.
You know what I'm excited about at Caulfield this weekend?
What?
Return of the champ. Surprise baby goes round.
Oh really?
You still like that horse?
Yeah, I love him.
For its annual two starts a year.
Yeah, he's back. He's
this
back.
This is lead up stable. For the Melbourne Cup.
It's bloody stable. Haley's Comet, this horse.
Is it in the last race?
I'm excited. He's in the ninth race. Last. Yeah. But yeah, I'm excited to see him back. He's a really good horse, and I hope he's back at his best.
So, what happened to a wider train stables to G Bedgood?
That's
Bedgood.
I'm not sure exactly why he changed stables, but he pulled up with an issue after that Melbourne Cup. So, I think he had a small operation, like a chip removed from his knee or something along those lines. But don't quote me. But he pulled up with an issue from that Melbourne Cup.
Interesting time to resume Surprise Baby just after the Melbourne Cup. But
yeah, I think it was a timeline thing. I just think that he had to have a bit of time out. I would think that they'll give him one run here. He'll go for another spell.
Jesus.
And then they'll bring him back for a Melbourne Cup campaign.
More so holidays than Hilton's, this horse.
So... This is its Melbourne. It's just starting off its Melbourne Cup prep by having one run here.
He'll have a run here, a fitness run, and then they just go make sure that he gets through it all. Go for a spell and
wait. Melbourne I'm going to have.
He might come back for one run in the autumn or something.
Let's bet. Let's have a futures bet, Pat.
I'm going to have $100 a week on it every week until the Melbourne Cup.
You should.
I don't know how you like this horse, Blake.
I want to murder it after what it did to you.
Yeah, we'll get it. We'll get it all back one day.
One day,
like a boomerang.
Okay. Rollover bet's done. Do you want to do a group multi?
Yep.
Yeah. Hey, just quickly before we get into the group multi, jeez, there is some racing at the Gold Coast this weekend. I'm not sponsored by Gold Coast.
Oh, I think the Gold Coast is probably going to be
Not going to call off. Not going to call off. No.
I think they are.
No, I can feel it. I can feel it in my waters.
It's a heavy 10 now.
It would be a heavy 10 now. They are not going to call it off.
Yeah.
It's 90% humidity on Saturday.
There's some big storms coming.
Yeah, I think I believe they're going to be gone by Friday. But we will be dealing with a heavy 8, I reckon, but geez, it'd be good. Oh, some of these.
If I was a betting man, I'd say they're going to be off.
Really?
Just having a look at the forecast.
Skull of beer?
It's gone. That meaning's gone.
I'll throw Elite Street in for my my leg.
All right. I'll throw Ellsberg in for my leg.
Sam, are you there?
I'm going to put it on too.
So what? I can't. So I shouldn't have a tip from the Gold Coast. Is there Arabian going to be racing? Yeah, Callow's on the Harrovian.
I wouldn't go to the Gold Coast. That's personally, unless you want
Callow's on the big have.
I think
the I've never tipped the scratching. I know that's big, something you guys are very much into, especially you, Blake.
It will be 100% on.
I reckon it's going to be on
it'll
too.
It'll be on.
100% off.
Are you coming from any...
They called Doombin off today.
Yeah, and it's Wednesday.
Yeah, and there's rain forecast for Thursday, Friday, and
Saturday. Mate, you don't understand. You don't live up here. You don't understand how the storms work. Those storms might not even come.
And Queensland as well. They're like, hey, bro, you want to race today? It's Wednesday, man. Let's just go to the pub.
I've got one. I like...
Let's go have a 4X. Yeah, bugger the races today. We'll just bet it.
They won't. No way. This is a big meme for Gold Coast. They need to keep it on.
Yeah, 100% will be on.
All right, the last leg of our multi should be Gold Coast getting caught off. But give us your tip.
Yeah.
Scratch. Oh, yes. Yeah. I've never tipped a scratching.
You're the scratched man.
Gold Coast race 4, number 6, War Daddy.
What happened to Callow on the Harrovian?
Mate.
My favourite jockey on my favourite horse.
Heavy 9.
Callow loves a weekend off anyway, so he'd be happy with that.
I feel like if it's 90 degrees, 90% humidity, he'd be really pushing for the race to be called off. If Gold Coast out, then...
You're out. See ya.
No, I like...
why didn't you just give us the other one?
Yeah, no, you can't redo it because...
No, that's
the I can have already I can on. Have a, I can have a thing. Yeah, it's right. Blake's multi. It's Blake's multi. I don't care about Blake's multi. Look how much I care about Blake's multi.
Well, I actually only put War Daddy in because I'm happy you tipped at Gold Coast because there's no way you'll be in the winner's circle 2 weeks in a row.
I've just been in the winner's circle 2 weeks in a row, thanks. Or 1.5 because I was sharing it with one of you two. I can't remember. You guys just blurs. I'm just
it's a heavy cross.
You guys are coming into the dance floor. You're leaving.
I'm hey, just, for, just, for everyone, just for everyone that listens, before the show, Woodhead was going through the run sheet with us. He goes, we've really got to make a big deal of the winner's circle. You know, when we're tipping $12 winners, we've really got to pump each other up. You know,
the boys are like, why do we do it every week? Is that doesn't matter. Don't worry about every week.
And then he hits us with, because I tipped Zaydani last week. You guys remember that? Yeah, thank you.
I texted you all. Remember I tipped Zaydani 4 days ago? Okay, let's give shirt away. Oh, we got our money back. Pat, I know you like the merch update.
Yeah.
We got the money back.
So I don't have to send the boys around.
We don't have to name names. We don't
have to call them out. He's lucky. I had the boys ready. I had them out of the cage.
He's about 25 minutes away from
hell,
legal and all sorts of stuff.
Unleashing hell.
Oh, it was happening. I had to leave it.
I nearly had to ring your blade.
I needed to be War Daddy. I was the War Daddy on the voicemail.
I got the guns out. Adam, ready. I was going to say, Blake, come pick me up. I'm ready.
Pat found his address. Can you believe this? Little sicko. You can take the boy out of Western Sydney. We haven't. We left him there. He's still there.
I'm still here. It was in the yellow pages. I'm doing this from a cell. It's hell in a cell.
All right. Give us a review. You got one, BJ? You got one, Patty?
I do have one.
Thanks, Blake.
I do have one from P Black.
Bit of theatre. P Black.
From P Black. Greatest racing podcast.
Two
exclamation marks. So he's obviously yelled that. A must listen for anyone looking to get their racing fix with some banter and fun for good measure.
Oh,
as someone who has been a punting tragic for a couple of decades, the boys podcast is the highlight of the week.
Oh,
P Black. Oh,
yeah. Blackie.
That is one of the best. P Black, reach out and the boys will send you out a pack.
Page, email, whatever. Just get in touch with us. Just need your address and shirt size, and you will be sorted, my friend.
P Black takes us to 190 ratings.
I think, mate, now it's catching us. We're the highest rated racing podcast on Apple iTunes. In the world, possibly the world. Unfortunately, no one will see it because we're in the football category. Thanks, Apple. Fight with you every fucking week about it.
They laugh. They're laughing.
They don't care. We've been messaging Zuckerberg saying, come on, get us in the wrong guy.
190 ratings, the same amount as five-star ratings that Sydney Wide Discounts has.
Okay. What a shameless plug.
Cutting edge mattresses that a horse can sleep on.
Anything else to add, gentlemen, or is that that for the day?
That's a wrap.
Well done, gents. I think next week or the week after is our last show for the year. We'll do a big wrap-up of the year. Favorite horse, race. We'll go through all that kind of stuff.
Also, favorite tipster?
Yeah, you guys get voting now. Who's your favorite tipster? Me? I'll go through.
Put a poll up.
Yep.
Put a poll up.
Put a poll up. And what? Just dance on it? Yes. Yeah. All right. That's it. See you, lads.
See you, mate. Fellas.